I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. We're going to be doing a cheesy broccoli rice casserole. And this recipe came to me from one of my sisters-in-law. She's a great cook, and this is a wonderful recipe. Makes a lot, so if you want to use it for holidays or for potluck dinners, it's a great thing. And also, it tastes so good, you'll want to use it just for every day. We'll start by doing our broccoli. What I have here is a package of frozen chopped broccoli. Now this is a 1 pound package, it's frozen. I really don't need more than half that. So if you find an 8 ounce box of frozen chopped broccoli, that would be enough to buy. But if you get the 16 ounce container like this, just use half of it and pour it into about an inch of rapidly boiling water. Over here I have some water that is just coming to a boil. It's 2 cups of water. What I plan to do with it is to use minute rice. That's rice that has been treated in such a form that it will cook very quickly. And I have 2 cups measured out. To go with those 2 cups of minute rice, I need 2 cups of water. But I need the water to be rapidly boiling. And it's almost getting there. As soon as that boils, I'm going to be putting my 2 cups of rice in there, covering it with a lid, and then I can just turn it off and forget about it, and in 5 minutes it will be plumped up and done. So I think it's about ready. I'm going to go ahead and pour the rice in, and I didn't have a spoon over here, so I'll just kind of shake that until it looks good. Put the lid on it, and I'm going to turn it off, and that will cook on its own. So give me a minute to get these 2 cooked, and then we'll be back and put this wonderful casserole together. My broccoli and rice are done, and you can see that I've already poured off the water. I have poured the broccoli through a colander in the sink, and I've saved the broccoli in a drained form. So we'll be using that in just a minute. I'm going to let it sit here for a while. The rice has set for 5 minutes. By the way, that was 3 minutes on the cooking of the broccoli. And you just fluff it with a fork and it's nice and done. So again, we're just going to let this sit and prepare the rest of the casserole. Those are ready. I'm going to begin this casserole by using 2 well-beaten eggs. So I've already put those in a very large mixing bowl. As I said, this makes a large casserole, so you don't want to start with a little bowl and then run out of space as you're trying to mix up your ingredients. I have some skim milk next, and what I have is 2/3 of a cup. So just add that in with your beaten egg. And next is cream of chicken soup. This is just a standard size can. Condensed soup, 10.75 ounces. And I have picked the kind that is 98% fat free. You can find various kinds, so whatever you like, go ahead and use that. And I'm going to borrow my spoon from over here and get this removed from the container and into my blend. Next item, and they don't have to be in this order necessarily, it's oil. And I've chosen canola oil. If you'd rather use another type like peanut oil, Wesson oil, anything, it just needs to be an oil that you put in. It's 1/2 cup. So let's remove our oil. Next I have 1 medium onion, which has been chopped, and you can see it's been done in a kitchen chopper. Because it's still in there. So let me get that out. That was just 1 medium onion, finely chopped. You don't want big coarse pieces in this casserole. Not of onion, at least. Now, I have another ingredient coming up, or a few more ingredients coming up, but I think that I will start blending this and getting the broccoli and the rice incorporated into it. So let's just stir this around. Remember, those are hot right now. It's preferable that you cool them down, but if you're kind of trying to get this together, then you may proceed. Just try not to cook the egg as you are adding the hot rice and the hot broccoli. But if you have plenty of time during the day as you're making this, just get those two things prepared ahead of time. Let them sit at room temperature and they'll cool down to the point where they won't be a problem at all. So let's grab our broccoli and just put that in and stir quickly so that the egg will be heated on all parts, not just in one spot. Don't want to come up with just cooked eggs. Get rid of that. And then our rice. Put that in. It should have absorbed all of its water. It might be a little watery at this point, but it will be absorbed as it bakes in the oven. So you see how this is growing into a very large casserole? Those yellow chunks are not cooked egg, they are chunks of the chicken soup. So I just need to mash a little bit to get those blended in. And this is working great. And it's going to be pretty when it's finished. That green of the broccoli, you want to cook it just the 3 minutes so that it is sort of tender crisp because it's going to be baked in the oven, but it will maintain that nice green look. And it's very pretty in this casserole. And that's somewhat blended. You could keep working on that, but this will be fine since it's going to be baked in the oven. Now I have 1 pound of shredded sharp cheddar cheese. That's the same as 4 cups. That's a lot of cheese. But this is a cheesy casserole. It is a large casserole. So it takes all 4 cups. Now you see why I needed a big bowl. And I'm going to need a big baking dish. So I've got a 13x9x2 dish, which I've already sprayed with cooking oil. Actually, I used canola oil to spray that, and it's sitting there ready and waiting for this. So I just need to do a little more stirring, and I've got a little bit of spices that I'm going to add in. I save that for last. It is to taste. I don't actually taste of it, but you have an idea of how much you or your family would like. So we're going to salt, pepper, and use garlic salt as well. So that's pretty well mixed, not quite done. Let me grab my salt and just give a good shake over the top because I'll be blending a little bit more. And then the pepper. Just a little bit. You can even leave that out if you don't want to see black specks in there. And it's not essential, but I do have garlic salt. And to taste, this comes out heavier, so we won't put too much of that in there. Now stirring a little bit more. The main idea here is to get that cheese spread out evenly. We don't want a big clump of cheese in one spot. And now we're ready to pour it into our casserole dish.
Spread this out.
I have an oven that is preheated to 325 degrees. And I'm expecting that it's going to take this 1.5 hours. Now I'll check the time. I'll set a timer and I'll know exactly how long it has taken. So I'll put this in the oven at 325 degrees, and I'll be back in about 1.5 hours. It's been only 1 hour, but I've been checking, and this is ready to come out. You can leave it longer, but I like it when it's nice and juicy, and I don't like it dried out. So I'm going to go ahead and take it out of the oven at 1 hour, but it would not hurt to stay longer. It just probably doesn't need the full 1.5 hours. To let you see the texture of it, if I just dip into this, it's nice and crunchy but not burned or anything like that on the edge. But you can see that nice brownness
It's just a lovely casserole.